My dear students, in previous lecture I have completed IUPAC nomenclature of the elements. Now I am going to start classification of elements into S, P, D and F blocks. Classification of elements into S, P, D and F blocks. See, we know that that modern periodic table or long form of periodic table contains 7 periods. These are called periods. Horizontal rows are called periods. These are called groups. There are 18 groups, 7 periods and 18 groups. So classification of elements into S, P, D and F blocks. On the basis of differentiating electron, elements are classified into 4 blocks. Differentiating electron is nothing but last entering electron. Suppose if we take lithium atomic number is 3, its electronic configuration we can write 1s2 2s1. This is last electron, this is differentiating electron. The last entering electron is called differentiating electron. If that electron enters into s subshell or s orbital, that element belongs to s block. Suppose if we take boron, its electronic configuration 1s2 2s2, 2p1. See, we know that first orbit contains only s subshell, that is 1s. If we take second orbit, it contains s and p subshells, 1s, 2s, 2p. This electronic configuration we will discuss in atomic structure lesson. This is first orbit. In the first orbit, only s subshell is present, 1s. Second orbit, 2s and 2p. So for boron, atomic number is 5. Atomic number 5 means it has 5 electrons. 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. So your last entering electron is present in p orbital. So boron belongs to p block. On the basis of differentiating electron, elements are classified into 4 blocks. S block elements, P block elements, D block elements and F block elements. See, first S block elements. S block elements means, see, the elements in which differentiating electron enters into the S orbitals of valence orbits are called S block elements. The elements in which differentiating electron enters into the S orbitals of valence orbit are called S block elements. So next, see here, if we take this is as nth orbit, this is last orbit now here. If this is nth orbit, then it should be n minus 1th orbit. It should be n minus 2 orbit. If this last orbit is nth orbit, it should be n minus 1th orbit. It should be n minus 2 orbit. This nth orbit is called valency orbit. That last orbit is called valency orbit or ultimate orbit. N minus 1th orbit is called penultimate orbit. N minus 2 orbit is called antepenultimate orbit. This nth orbit is valency orbit or ultimate orbit. Nth orbit is ultimate or valency orbit. N minus 1 orbit is penultimate orbit. N minus 2 orbit is prepenultimate or antepenultimate orbit. So in case of S block elements, differentiating electron enters into the S orbitals of valency orbit. This is S subshell. This S subshell can accommodate 2 electrons. S subshell contains only 1 orbital. So if we take S subshell, it contains only 1 orbital. If we take P subshell, it contains 3 orbitals. If we take D subshell, it contains 5 orbitals. all these are there in atomic structure lesson. Even 10th class also we have S subshell contains one orbital, P subshell contains three orbitals, D subshell contains five orbitals, F subshell contains seven orbitals. S subshell contains only one orbital, that one orbital can accommodate only two electrons. That's why S block contains two groups in the periodic table, that S orbitals or S subshell can accommodate two electrons. Hence S block contains only two groups. They are first A and second A. See, these are the S block elements, first A group elements and second A group elements. First A group elements are hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium. First A group elements. These are the first A group elements. First A group elements are also called alkali metals. First A group elements are called alkali metals. First A group elements valence orbital electronic configuration is NS1. First A group elements electronic configuration is NS1. If we take hydrogen, 1s1. If we take lithium, 1s2, 2s1. Then for sodium, 3s1. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. So general valence orbit electronic configuration is NS1. Next, second A group elements: beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, radium. These are the second A group elements. Second A group elements are also called alkaline earth metals. Alkaline earth metals. Their electronic configuration is NS2. Second A group elements, valence orbit electronic configuration is NS2. See, all are metals only except this hydrogen. See, here in this modern periodic table, hydrogen is placed in first A group. But still the position of hydrogen is uncertain. Even at present also, there is uncertainty in the position of that hydrogen. Just for our convenience, we have placed in first A group, but there is uncertainty in the position of hydrogen. So except this hydrogen, all are metals only. See, first A group elements, except hydrogen, first A group elements are called alkali metals. This hydrogen is not metal. Except hydrogen, remaining first A group elements are called alkali metals. Second A group elements are called alkaline earth metals. That means all S block elements are metals. All are metals. S block elements are metals. All S block elements are metals except that hydrogen. These S block elements form ionic compounds. They form ionic compounds except lithium and beryllium. Except this lithium and beryllium, remaining S block elements form ionic compounds. They have more tendency to form ionic compounds. This is about S block elements. See, first definition I give: the elements in which differentiating electron enters into the S orbitals of valence orbit are called S block elements. S orbitals can accommodate two electrons. Hence, S block contains two groups. They are first A and second A. First A group and second A group. First A group elements. These are the first A group elements. Except hydrogen, except this hydrogen, remaining first A group elements are called alkali metals. For alkali metals, general valence orbit electronic configuration is NS1. Here this N is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 only, up to 7. Second A group elements: beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, radium. These are the second A group elements. Second A group elements are called alkaline earth metals. Second A group elements, general valence orbit electronic configuration is NS2. Except hydrogen, all these are metals. So all S block elements are metals. These elements have more tendency to form ionic compounds, except lithium and beryllium. Due to their small size, they can form covalent compounds. This is about S block elements. So next to P block elements. Next, P block elements. I say P block elements means the elements in which differentiating electron enters into the P orbitals of valency orbit. See, this is valency orbit, nth orbit. The elements in which differentiating electron enters into the P orbitals of valency orbit are called P block elements. Next, second point. See, this P subshell, contains three orbitals, 1, 2, 3. This each box corresponding to one orbital. P subshell contains three orbitals, 1, 2, 3, three orbitals. Each orbital can accommodate 2 electrons. Then P subshell can accommodate 6 electrons. Na? That's why P block contains 6 groups. P block contains 6 groups. They are, see, third A, fourth A, fifth A, sixth A, seventh A, and zero. So P block elements are from third A to zero. Third A group elements, boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium, neonium. Fourth A group elements, carbon, silicon, germanium, tin, lead, fluorovium, neonium, fluorovium, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth, muscovium, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium, livermorium, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine, tennessine, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon, boganesson. See, don't bother about these names. See, because it is difficult to remember at a time. Again, in first year only we have one lesson. First A group elements lesson is there. S block is there. In that S block, we have first A group elements and second A group elements. Next, third A group elements is also there. Fourth A group elements is also there. In second PU, we have fifth A group elements, sixth A group elements, seventh A group elements, and zero group elements. Even D block elements and F block elements also. Now only no need to worry, no need to remember all these elements. So P subshell can accommodate 6 electrons. Na? That's why P block contains 6 groups. These are the 6 groups. They are from third A to zero. See, third A group. These are the third A group elements. Third A group elements valence orbit electron configuration is NS2, NP1. If you take boron, its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. So valence electron is present in the p orbital. So it belongs to p block. For third A group elements, ns2, np1. For fourth A group elements, ns2, np2. For third A group elements, ns2, np1. For fourth A group elements, ns2, np2. For fifth A group elements, ns2, np3. For sixth A group elements, NH2 NP4. For 7th group elements, NH2 NP5. For 0 group elements, NH2 NP6. NH2 NP6. P block contains 6 groups. They are from 3rd A to 0. For 3rd A group elements, NH2 NP1. For 0 group, NH2 NP6. So for P block elements, we can write NH2 NP126. For S block elements, S block contains 2 groups. For first A group elements, NS1. For second A group elements, NS2. We can write NS122. S block contains 2 groups, first A, second A. First A group elements valence electronic configuration is NS1. Second A group elements valence electronic configuration is NS2. Then for S block elements, we can write NS122. NS122. Like that, for P block elements, we can write NS2, NP126. See, first, third A group. For third A group elements, NS2, NP1. Next, fourth A group elements, NS2, NP2. For zero group, NS2, NP6. So, 126. NS2, NP126. This is P block elements, general valency orbit electronic configuration. For P block elements, general valency orbit general valency orbit, electronic configuration, NH2NP 126. These are the third A group elements. These are the fourth A group elements. Third A group elements are boron family. In the third A group, first element is boron, so boron family. Fourth A group elements are carbon family. Fifth A group elements are nitrogen family. Sixth A group elements are chalcogens. Sixth A group elements are also called chalcogens. Seventh A group elements are called halogens. Halogens. Sixth A group elements are called chalcogens. Seventh A group elements are called halogens. Zero group elements, noble gases. This P block contains all types of elements: metals, non-metals, and metalloids. P block contains all types of elements: metals, metals, non-metals, and metalloids. This S block contains only metals, na? But P block contains metals, non-metals, and metalloids. Generally, first elements are non-metals, last elements are metals, middle elements are metalloids. Generally, first elements are non-metals, last elements are metals, middle elements are metalloids. This is about P block elements. Next, D block elements. So in case of S block elements and P block elements, differentiating electron enters into the valency orbit. In case of S and P block elements, differentiating electron, last entering electron, enters into the nth orbit. But in case of D block elements, these are the D block elements. In case of D block elements, differentiating electron enters into the n minus 1th orbit. So D block elements means the elements in which differentiating electron enters into the d orbitals of penultimate orbit. Are called D block elements. The elements in which differentiating electron enters into the d orbitals of penultimate orbit. See, in previous class already I have explained 1s, 2s, 3s, 4s for potassium valence orbital electronic configuration 4s1. So this is fourth period, 4s1, 4s2. After 4s2 is filled, after this 4s is filled, then differentiating electron enters into 3d orbitals. This is 4s. After this 4s is filled, here still 3d is vacant only. This 3d is vacant only. After 4s, differentiating electron enters into these 3d orbitals. So in case of d block elements, differentiating electron enters into the this penultimate orbit, not valency orbit, na, penultimate orbit. After 4s is filled, differentiating electron enters into 3d orbitals. In general, we can write after ns is filled, then differentiating electron enters into n minus 1d orbitals. Because after 4s, 3d. After 5s, 4d. After 6s, 5d. After 7s, 6d. So, differentiating electron enters into n minus 1d orbitals. The elements in which differentiating electron enters into the d orbitals of penultimate orbit, not valency orbit, d orbitals of penultimate orbit, are the elements in which differentiating electron enters into the n minus 1d orbitals. In case of S and P block elements, differentiating electron enters into nth orbit, that is valency orbit. In case of these elements, ns orbitals. In case of these elements, np orbitals. But here not nd orbitals, n minus 1d orbitals. In case of these elements, differentiating electron enters into n minus 1d orbitals. So that d subshell contains 5 orbitals. D subshell contains 5 orbitals. See 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Each orbital can accommodate 2 electrons, means total 5 orbitals are there, means it can accommodate 10 electrons. D subshell can accommodate 10 electrons. That's why D block contains 10 groups. D block contains 10 groups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. D orbitals or D subshell can accommodate 10 electrons. Hence, D block contains 10 groups. They are from 3rd B to 2nd B. They are from 3rd B to 2nd B. Here 3rd B, next 4th B, 5th B, 6th B, 7th B, 8th, like that. Or according to IUPAC, 3 to 12. This is 3. According to IUPAC, groups are numbered continuously 1 to 18. 1, 2, 3, 3 to 12. So D block contains 10 groups. They are from 3rd B to 2nd B. 3rd B to 2nd B. Or 3 to 12. 3 to 12. D block contains 10 groups. They are from 3rd B to 2nd B. Or 3 to 12. Next, D block elements general valence orbit electronic configuration is n minus 1d, 1 to 10, ns 0 to 2. For D block elements, general valence orbit electronic configuration is n minus 1d, 1 to 10. So this D subshell can accommodate 10 electrons. Na? So 1 to 10. See, for this, 4s1, 4s2, next 3d1. Here zinc is there. Scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, ferrous, cobalt, nickel, copper, zinc. 3d1 to 3d10. But here some elements exhibit anomalous electronic configuration. That's why I took 0 to 2. For some elements, there is no s electrons. For most of the elements, 2 electrons are there in the s subshell. But for some elements, there is no s electrons. Or there may be 1 electron. That's why I wrote 0 to 2. 0 or 1 or 2. N minus 1d, 1 to 10, ns 0 to 2. Here don't write n means 1, 2, 3, 4, so on like that. N should be 4, 5, 6, 7 only. If n is equal to 4, 4 minus 1, 3d. This is a 3d series is formed. Here if n is equal to 4, 4 minus 1, 3, 3d. 3d series is formed. If n is equal to 5, 5 minus 1, 4d series. This is 4d series. If n is equal to 6, 6 minus 1, 5, 5d, 5d series. If n is equal to 7, 7 minus 1, 6d, 6d series is formed. So here, this is 3d series. In that 3d series, first element is scandium, last element is zinc. In 4d series, first element is yttrium, last element is cadmium. In 5d series, first element is lanthanum, last element is mercury. Last series, 3d, 4d, 5d, 6d. First element is actinium, last element is CN. CN means copernicium. Copernicium. All D block elements are metals only. All these D block elements are metals. All are metals. All are metals. This is about D block elements. S block elements, P block elements, D block elements. Next, last one, F block elements. In case of S block elements and P block elements, differentiating electron enters into the valency orbit, that is nth orbit. In case of D block elements, differentiating electron enters into the d orbitals of penultimate orbit, that is n minus 1 d orbitals. But in case of F block elements, differentiating electron enters into n minus 2 orbit. If this is nth orbit, it should be n minus 1th orbit. It should be n minus 2 orbit. See 6s1, 6s2, 6th period, 6s, 6s1, 6s2, after 6s, next 4f. After 6s is filled, next differentiating electron enters into 4f orbitals. So that means
Here if it is 6s, after 6s is filled, then differentiating electron enters into 4f orbitals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 4f orbitals.
After 6s is filled,
then differentiating electron enters into 4f orbitals.
So in case of f lock elements, differentiating electron enters into the f orbitals of pre-tenantiomate orbit. So the elements, f lock elements means the elements in which differentiating electron enters into the f orbitals of pre-tenantiomate orbit or anti-tenantiomate orbit. The elements in which differentiating electron enters into the f orbitals of pre-tenantiomate orbit or anti-tenantiomate orbit are called f lock elements. So n minus 2 f orbitals. Differentiating electron enters into ns orbitals. Differentiating electron enters into np orbitals. Differentiating electron enters into n minus 1d orbitals. Differentiating electron enters into n minus 2 f orbitals. N minus 2 f orbitals. S subshell contains 2 electrons, hence S block contains 2 groups. P subshell can accommodate 6 electrons, hence P block contains 6 groups. D subshell can accommodate 10 electrons, hence D block contains 10 groups. F subshell can accommodate 14 electrons. F subshell can accommodate 14 electrons, but F orbitals, F lock does not contain 14 groups. F subshell or F orbitals can accommodate 14 electrons because 7 orbitals are there. 7 orbitals are there. So F subshell can accommodate 14 electrons, but F lock does not contain 14 groups. F lock contains 2 series of elements, 4F series and 5F series. The elements in which differentiating electron enters into the n minus 2 f orbitals are called f lock elements. F subshell can accommodate 14 electrons, but f lock does not contain 14 groups. F lock contains only 2 series of elements, 4f series, 5f series. 4f series elements are called lanthanides. 4f series elements are called lanthanides, or we can say that lanthanones. Lanthanides or lanthanones are rare earths because their availability in earth crust is very less. So they are called rare earths. Next, 5F series elements, actinides. They are called actinides. General valence orbital electronic configuration of f lock elements is n minus 2f, 1 to 14, n minus 1d, 0 to 1, ns 2. N minus 2f, this f can accommodate 14 electrons, no? So 1 to 14. See, 1 to 14. First element is cerium, last element is lutetium, cerium to lutetium, 5F series elements. First element is thorium, last element is laurentium, LR. In case of 4F series elements, first element is cerium, its atomic number 58. 71, thorium to laurentium, 92-103. So, F-lock elements, general valence orbital electronic configuration is n minus 2F, 1 to 14, n minus 1D, 0 to 1, NS2. Here, n value 6 or 7 only, 6 and 7 only. We should not write 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. If n is equal to 6, 6 minus 2, 4F, 4F series is formed. If n is equal to 7, 7 minus 2, 5f, 5f series is formed. All these are metals only. All are metals. So except hydrogen, all s block elements, all d block elements and all f block elements are metals. except this hydrogen, all these S block elements, D block elements and F block elements are metals. Only this P block contains all types of elements. This is P block. Only this P block contains all types of elements. This is classification of elements into blocks.